Automating material removal processes in your manufacturing line can bring highly sought after efficiencies, especially in processes that are 3D. I'm talking dull, dirty, and dangerous. In this video, I'll walk you through the process of removing concrete buildup on large metal forms. These forms are used and reused in the building of concrete structures all around us, such as bridges, parking garages, and even stadiums. In between uses, the forms that hold the concrete undergo a rough cleanup to get the surfaces back to a suitable finish before they are used again. The current manual process utilizes a team of people removing the residual concrete with wire cut brushes. The work is physically demanding, generates concrete dust, and is repetitive. An automated process can reduce the physical toll on operators who have to hold and manipulate the grinders. We were able to clean the forms using a PushCorp AFD310 compliance device and an STC0605-BT30, a high-torque robotic spindle. With concrete being such a hard material that can seem daunting to remove, you might think you would need PushCorp's largest spindle and compliance device. Testing through the demo lab allows us to spec in the right size equipment for the job. The AFD310 is an active force compliance tool capable of applying up to 60 pounds of force in any orientation. The STC0605-BT30 boasts 5 horsepower and a max RPM of 6,000. Its automatic tool changing feature may not be necessary in this case unless you need to swap the size of abrasives. The SM0605 servo manual tool change version could make sense in this application as the wire wheels are long lasting. It has a manual ER collet requiring an operator to change out the media, but simplifying the overall system. Sometimes our customers find themselves with a high mix of parts, meaning there is variability in size and shape of their parts, or they have varying levels and locations of material buildup. This project had both. The current manual process utilizes a wire cut brush, which works well with hand tools. To take advantage of the robot's rigidity and repeatability, we switched to a wire wheel. Increasing RPMs and force tends to spread out the wires of the cut brush, reducing its cutting action. The wheel holds its shape and allowed us to get a more aggressive cut. In the lab, we tested various wire wheels and landed on a wheel provided by Norton St. Gobain. It was a 10-inch diameter by 1/2-inch width twisted wire wheel brush with a wire gauge of 20,000ths. We started the test using a single wheel, but ended up stacking two together to cover more surface area with each pass. A challenge on this project was the differing levels of concrete on the returning parts. Some returned from the field fairly clean, while others had much more buildup. A person will naturally see the areas with more material to remove and dwell longer there with their grinder. Depending on the customer's goals, a robotic integrator can apply a variety of methods to handle this. For an advanced system, vision can be implemented to detect and process these areas automatically. Another solution would be to have the robotic path broken up into different program sections. Then using an HMI, a human operator can select the area that needs to be run again and even adjust the force if needed. Ultimately, the end user will help steer these decisions based on their system requirements. During their use, the forms can get dented. These pockets were difficult to access with the diameter of wheel we were using. The customer would have to weigh if it makes sense to do a tool change to a smaller wheel or have an operator do touch-ups as they unload the part. In the proof of concept lab, two techniques were tested. First, we tried dragging the wheel rotated 90 degrees to our path. This flattened out the bottom of the wheel and gave us the largest contact patch for each pass. Then we tried running the wheel in line with our path. This gave us the best cut as the wires were supported by the other twisted bundles on either side. Let's put this all together and check out the application video. Hey, welcome back. We create these videos to help explain material removal applications. If you have a process you think might be right for automation and want to see your parts in the demo lab, send an email to sales@pushcorp.com. If you enjoy these videos, please make sure to like and subscribe. We'll put a link to another cleaning process in the video description below, exploring paint stripping. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.